Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and today I want to answer the question about what are those dark spots on the stems of your roses and what should you do about them. Here I have an example from my greenhouse of one that has these purplish reddish spots on the stems, but also I can give you examples from around the landscape as well, including the one that I pruned in a video last week. So what are they? The description of them will vary a little bit between purplish reddish, that's the way I describe these ones here. Some people will call them brown or black spots, and the organism that causes them actually varies quite a bit. The University of Illinois Extension Service guide indicated most directly towards black spot, and that's totally credible. It's a disease of roses, and it does overwinter in its spores on the stems without actually causing any damage to the stems. If you look on the Missouri Botanical Garden Guide, however, they have exactly the same kinds of pictures, but they pinpoint the most likely organism as botrytis, but then they also say in the same article that it could be a wide variety of different canker-related organisms on the stems of your roses. All of that sounds really alarming, and I can see you running out to the shed now to grab your pruners, to look for it in your garden and cut it out, but not so fast. I really think that you should consider the condition and the impact of that pruning on your roses before you go forward. The difference between this and leaves are generally a very inexpensive part of the plant. That doesn't mean that nutrients and resources don't go into the making of leaves, but they are in fact disposable parts. So if you see black spot on leaves, pull off the black spot. It's a pretty low cost activity for your rose, and it will help to reduce the spores of the fungus that are in your rose. Stems, on the other hand, are a very important part of your rose. They build the framework. They are the next spot where the buds will emerge, and the plant has invested significant amounts of energy and has stored significant amount of energy into the stems of your roses. So if you remove a whole bunch of those, particularly on a weak or slow growing variety, you may be left with a nub and a very poor performer, and you may as well in that case just give up on the rose itself. I want to share with you an article I saw on WHOS, which I think was formerly GardenWeb, that illustrates some of my points, some things that I agree with in your approach to pruning away darker spots on the stems of your roses. This response was posted in a thread called "What are these red spots on my rose canes and are they bad?" And I'll post a link to the thread here below the video, but you'll see pictures in there that will be familiar to anybody who grows roses, of the little purplish red spots that you can see on your rose canes. And a lot of other people had commented back saying, hey, you should cut that away. It's canker. It's dangerous. It'll spread. It's going to cut down your rose. The answer I liked the best, and it's actually at the top of the list, is the featured answer from Michael G, is I'll paraphrase here. The spots pictured could be nascent canker, but are probably something else. Black spot fungus can make red spots on the bark. It's the main way that black spot overwinters. There are probably many causes of red spots. True cankers may start with such spots, but develop into larger areas of dead bark, black or brown, usually with concentric zoning of two colors. Do an image search for rose stem canker. There are several kinds. Here's the part I like the best. Spores of fungal diseases are always present in a rose garden, so sanitation efforts have limited value. It's possible to do a lot of damage with pruning shears in a panicky attempt to prevent the spread of imaginary disease, or a futile attempt to prevent the spread of a real one. Fungal diseases take hold and spread mainly on account of very particular weather conditions. I never prune out healthy wood because of red spots, and my roses have done well for decades. I don't prune out every actual canker either. The rose's immune system will usually contain the canker until it becomes inactive. A rule of thumb you'll find in older rose books is to prune if the canker has girdled half the circumference of the stem. Michael G, whoever you are, I love your non-alarmist approach to gardening. If I find dark spots on the stems of my roses, I definitely want to consider the overall condition of the rose plant before I make any drastic decisions, and I want to take a common sense approach. So I'll give you three different scenarios here. If I, of course, had an otherwise healthy rose with a good framework of stems, but only a few that had dark spots on them, then of course, by all means, take out the dark spotted stems and leave the healthy ones? That's an easy question. The second one is, if you have something that has widespread dark spots all over the stems, and it's a weaker or slower or newly establishing rose, I think you might be doing more harm than good by taking off a significant portion of stems. At this point, I would probably just give it a light prune, focusing on the stuff that's congesting the center of the rose, so just the regular structural pruning that you would do on roses, and then I would follow up with trying to feed it, trying to water it, make sure it has a good site, and try to help it to grow through the worst of that disease. If you want to revisit it later, you certainly can. The third scenario I give you is if you have a large, well-established, vigorous rose that has dark spots on its stems, and you notice that botrytis is coming up in the season every year, it might be a decent idea to give it a really hard, low prune at one point or another, just to see if that reduces the disease pressure. In general, larger, more vigorous roses that are well established will recover from a deep prune like that very well, so it isn't as much of a risk as it would be on a smaller or slower growing rose. All right, that's all I have for you on dark spots on the stems of roses today. If you have any questions on this, something I've forgotten to say, please drop that below in the comments of the video. And thanks again for watching.